Peter, tomorrow will mark the debut of a faster legal route for women who've been raped. And for many here, it can't come soon enough.
In the chill of a new Delhi morning, a prayer keeps the vigil for justice alive. The anger still simmers nearly 2 weeks after she died. And they, who didn't even know her, now live only to see her murderers pay. Some even refusing to eat until that happens. The grotesque attack last month was a bruising blow for relatively safe and prosperous Delhi. Also tough, the uneasy conversation after, and waking up to what is a pervasive problem. In some parts, like this northern Delhi neighborhood plagued with sexual violence, there's a new push to bring it all out in the open.
Does this change?
They organize councils of women to deal with complaints of harassment and rape. Their success stories publicly displayed to encourage speaking up as opposed to keeping quiet.
So what kind of problems?
Like outside the schools, boys do molestations. Then the group members, all group members try to solve the problem through legal aid, through their like counseling, providing them a little bit empowerment.
Empowering women is one part of the answer. Another is changing attitudes. Easy to say, but so hard to do.
Yes, this particular case is so monstrous, so horrific.
Key, though, will be delivering that badly wanted justice in this one specific case. Right now, the vast majority of reported rapists are never convicted.
If it's not a speedy trial, then the anger against the government and the system will only increase. So I think everybody realizes that this particular trial should take place as quickly and as clinically as possible.
The case is being fast-tracked to assuage public anger, but a judge did confirm today that despite some opposition, it will be heard behind closed doors. Peter.